In this video, we are going to prove this double inequality. For convenience, we are going to let the P for this product. We just need to prove P is between the two fractions. So let's prove P is bigger than this fraction first. So now let's write down the P first. So P equals 1 over 2 times 3 over 4, then 5 over 6, then the last term, then here is 1998. So then how to prove the first inequality? So we're going to do this. So for each fraction, we keep the numerator the same. Okay, so we're going to do this. So keep the numerator on top. So then on the bottom, we're going to increase by 1. So 2 plus 1, that's 3. So then you see, when the bottom increase, so fraction is getting smaller. So 1 over 2 is bigger than this fraction. So then we do the same thing for the next one. Keep the numerator the same. Bottom increase by 1, that's 5. So 3 over 4 is bigger than this fraction. Now let's see. So here, so bottom increase by 1. So the fraction is getting smaller. Then keep going until the last one. Then the bottom increase by 1. So then this fraction is bigger than this one. Because each fraction on top is bigger than the corresponding fraction down here. So that's why here is bigger than. Okay, so now let's simplify. You see here, 3 and 3 canceled. 5, 5 canceled. So then 7 with 1 here canceled. So then 1,997 canceled out the 1 here. So then the only term left on top, that's the first one, that is 1. The only term left on the bottom, that's the last one. So that's 1,999. So now we got this result. So that is P is bigger than 1 over 1,999. So then we just prove the first inequality. We label this result as 1. In order to prove the second inequality, we need to prove a result first. So that is if we have n over n plus 1, then both top and bottom divided by n. Then here we have 1 over n. So let's compare this fraction with this one. Everything the same. Only thing is here. So here increase by 1. Okay, so let's compare these two fractions. Which is bigger? Because for the smaller fraction here, so the bottom increased by 1. Increase. So then this fraction getting smaller. Then this denominator is getting smaller. So then this big fraction is getting bigger. So here is, this one is less than this fraction. Okay, so now let's simplify this one. So simplify this one, both top and bottom times n plus 1. So here is n plus 1. Then here n plus 1 plus 1. So here we have n plus 2. Okay, so then we got this result. So here we have, so n over n plus 1 is less than this fraction, n plus 1 over n plus 2. So this is an important result we're going to use to prove the second inequality. Okay, so now let's see the second inequality. We are going to prove P is less than 1 over 44. Okay, so first we need to write down the P. Okay, so let's write down the P here. So P is 1 over 2, 3 over 4, then 5 over 6, then the last one. Okay, so the first step, we're going to do this. So for each fraction, we're going to apply this inequality. So now let's see. So here's 1 over 2. So 1 over 2 is less than both top and bottom plus 1. Okay, so 1 over 2 is less than top plus 1, that's a 2. Bottom plus 1 is a 3. Okay, so do the same thing for 3 over 4. 3 over 4 is less than both top and bottom plus 1. So less than 4 over 5. And do the same thing for this fraction. So less than 6 over 7. Then keep going until the last one. So the last fraction is less than top plus 1. The bottom plus 1. Because each fraction on top is less than the corresponding fraction on the bottom. So that's why here is less than. Okay. So the next. So next, we are going to keep all the numerators the same. Okay, so now let's see here. Keep all the numerators same. Then we're going to do something to the denominator. Okay, so we are going to shift all the denominators one place to the right. So instead of putting 3 here, so we're going to put the 3 here. Okay, instead of here, we're going to put here. So then starting from here, so then 5, put here. The next one, 7, keep going. So then the last term will be here. Then what's this term? The odd number before this one is 1,997. Okay, then what's here? So this one, we just put the 1. Okay, then what's here? So this one just 1. So it's the only thing we did, which is move all the denominators one place to the right. Because here's a product, so nothing changed. Okay, so now let's see why we are doing this. So now let's compare this group with P. You see, so on top is all the odd numbers, but now it's on the bottom. So all the even numbers on the bottom, now on the top. So that's why actually, so this one, this group is simply just 1 over P. It's a reciprocal of a P. So that's the important part. So now let's times the last one, 1 over 999. Okay, so now let's see what we have here. So that is P is less than this part. Okay, so let's write down here. So now we have P is less than 1 over P times this fraction. So then both sides times P. So then we have P squared less than this fraction. Okay, so then what is the inequality we try to prove? We try to prove P is less than 1 over 44. So then we're just hoping P squared is less than 1 over 44 squared. So now let's put it here. So we're just hoping we can figure out P squared is less than 44 squared. Okay, so now let's see what is a 44 squared. So that's just 1,936. So now let's compare these two fractions. So when the bottom getting smaller, so this fraction is getting bigger. So that means this fraction is less than this fraction. So what we got here? So that means we got P squared is less than 1 over 44 squared. Then both sides take a square root. So we have P less than 1 over 44. So then we just prove the second inequality. So now let's combine the first result with the second result. So then we have P is bigger than 1 over 1,999 less than 1 over 44, which is proof the inequality. Thanks for watching. See you next time.